Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. Now that we have gone through the processes of using alpha in ConnectFX, we now begin the last part of our journey, getting alpha out of ConnectFX and back into the sequence. As an example, we have a graphical promo. In this scenario, the background changes every version, but the graphics stay the same. Looking at a workflow, it is a good idea to separate the graphics from the background so that the background images can be editorially changed without having to redo the graphics every time. Now the final graphics was generated in a ConnectFX segment. In order to successfully composite the graphics over the background, we need to enable the ConnectFX to supply a fill and an alpha channel. To start this example, I have a sequence with some shots on the first layer. On the second layer, I am going to create a gap effect by slicing and selecting the virtual segment. I'll click the effects button and add a ConnectFX. In the interests of time, I will load an already made setup with the graphics. To output this to the sequence, you need to connect the last output into the CFX result node. If I exit ConnectFX, you will see that the graphics is not keying through to reveal the background. So we have to go back into ConnectFX. You can select the last node and press F4 a few times to cycle between the result and the alpha channel. So why is the alpha not keying the gap segment in the sequence? Well, you also need to connect the alpha channel to the CFX result node. Drag the matte output into the blue matte input of the CFX result node. Notice how the symbol changes on the CFX result from CFX to CFXA. This means that the CFX result is now considering the alpha coming out of ConnectFX. Exiting ConnectFX, the graphics are now keying over the background. This works for two reasons, of which the first you already know. The first is the alpha channel coming out of ConnectFX. The second reason is that an axis timeline effects has automatically been added to the gap segment when the alpha was connected to the CFX result node. Remember that the axis timeline effects is used to key any image with its alpha in the sequence. Therefore, it is intentionally added to the ConnectFX segment. The ConnectFX segment and the axis timeline effects will require rendering to output a final result. To sum up, it doesn't really matter how deep you go into ConnectFX. You always have the ability to get the alpha back to the sequence in order to composite with other underlying video tracks in the edit. In the next video, I'll show you how to prepare your RGB fill and alpha in order to export out of Smoke. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning Channel for future videos.